Where do Lithuanians really come from? For centuries, this question has puzzled historians and scientists alike. Some say Lithuanians are the last true descendants of the ancient Balts, one of Europe's oldest peoples. Others believe their roots go even deeper, reaching back to the very first humans who settled in northern Europe after the Ice Age. Now, for the first time, DNA is giving us real answers. And what scientists have discovered is nothing short of shocking. So stay with me until the end, because we're about to uncover the hidden truths behind Lithuanian DNA, a story that reaches back thousands of years to the dawn of Europe itself. But before we dive in, let me ask you a question. Do you think Lithuanians are the last descendants of the ancient Balts? Long before the words Lithuania or Baltic were spoken, the northern lands were home to small bands of hunter-gatherers. These people lived in forests and along the coasts, surviving through fishing, hunting, and gathering wild plants. Their world was silent, untouched by cities, untouched by empire. When the Ice Age ended and the glaciers pulled back, they followed the animals north and settled near the Baltic Sea. They became some of the first humans to walk on what is now Lithuanian soil. Scientists call them the Western hunter-gatherers, but you can think of them as Europe's original survivors. Tall, strong, with dark hair and blue eyes, they lived close to nature for thousands of years. They had no kings, no palaces, just an unbroken bond with the land. Around 8,000 years ago, a new wave of people began moving into Europe. They came from the south, the early farmers, bringing with them seeds, animals, and a new way of life. These farmers transformed the continent, but not here, not in the Baltics. While the rest of Europe turned to farming and built villages, the ancestors of Lithuanians held on to the old ways. They fished the rivers, hunted the forests, and watched as the new world spread around them. In the DNA record, this is where Lithuania stands apart. The Baltic lands became a kind of genetic time capsule, a place where the oldest European bloodlines survived almost untouched. It's rare in human history for a population to remain this stable for so long. But the people of the north had geography on their side. Thick forests, cold winters, and remote coasts protected them from the waves of invasion that swept across Europe. While ancient cities rose and fell in the Mediterranean and the Middle East, the Baltic tribes quietly endured, keeping something pure, something ancient alive. And this is the first secret scientists discovered. Lithuanian DNA carries one of the deepest ancestral lineages in all of Europe, older than Rome, older than Greece, a direct echo of the first Europeans who ever lived here. But then, everything changed. Around 5,000 years ago, a new kind of people appeared on the horizon. They came riding horses across the endless grasslands of the east, a vast region known as the Pontic-Caspian Steppe, stretching from Ukraine to Kazakhstan. Archaeologists once thought Europe's story began with farmers and cities. But when scientists examined ancient DNA, they found that around 3000 BC, the Yamnaya people spread across the continent like wildfire. And when they reached the lands of the Baltics, they met the ancient hunter-gatherers who had been there since the Ice Age. From that fusion came something entirely new, a new genetic identity, a new way of life, and a new language family that would one day become Indo-European, the root of hundreds of modern tongues. Today, scientists can trace this moment in Lithuanian DNA. It's there in the markers for the steppe ancestry, the same blood that flowed through the early Indo-Europeans who spread into India, Persia, and Western Europe. Modern Lithuanians carry some of the highest levels of steppe DNA in all of Europe, more than most Germans, more than most Scandinavians, and far more than Southern Europeans. That discovery was a shock even to researchers, because it means the Lithuanians are not just a northern people. They are a living genetic bridge between Europe's first hunters and the steppe warriors who brought language and movement across the ancient world. The Lithuanians are one of the closest living descendants of the original Indo-Europeans. So when you hear the Lithuanian language, those sharp consonants, that strange rhythm, you are hearing something older than empire, a whisper from the dawn of civilization itself. Now, let's talk about language, because here too, Lithuania holds a secret. Of all the languages in Europe, Lithuanian might sound the strangest to outsiders, but to linguists, it's like a time machine. Because it preserves the ancient sounds and grammar of the Proto-Indo-European language, the common ancestor of nearly every European tongue. In fact, many linguists say that Lithuanian is the closest living language to Proto-Indo-European, even closer than Latin, Greek, or Sanskrit. Take the word dūmas in Lithuanian. It means smoke. In Sanskrit, an ancient language of India, the word is dūma, almost identical. The connection is not coincidence. And this isn't just linguistic trivia. It's proof that Lithuania preserved not only ancient genes, but the ancient voice of humanity's first great culture. As empires rose and fell, as Latin became French and Greek faded into history, the Baltic tribes held on to their primal tongue, passed from parent to child, unbroken through millennia. This is what makes Lithuania not just a nation, but a mirror of Europe's forgotten origins. But this story isn't just about ancient DNA or old words. It's also about survival, about how a people kept their identity alive through the fires of history. For thousands of years, the Baltic tribes lived on the edges of great empires. Rome never conquered them. The Crusaders tried. The Teutonic Knights marched north in the name of God, and still, the Lithuanians resisted. They were among the last pagans in Europe, holding on to their old faith long after their neighbors had converted to Christianity. Even as trade routes opened and empires expanded, the Baltic people remained relatively isolated. They married among themselves, kept their traditions, and guarded their language like treasure. And when the Middle Ages arrived, something remarkable happened. The Lithuanians didn't vanish, they rose. By the 13th century, they had built one of the largest states in Europe, the Grand Duchy of Lithuania, stretching from the Baltic to the Black Sea. A vast, multicultural realm that stood shoulder to shoulder with kingdoms like Poland and Hungary. But even as the Grand Duchy expanded, its heart remained distinct. Archaeologists and geneticists confirm that the core Lithuanian DNA stayed remarkably stable through these centuries. Yes, there was some mixing. Slavs, Balts, Finnic tribes, but the foundation remained the same. Even under the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, under Tsarist Russia, and under Soviet rule, the genetic core endured. That's what makes Lithuania's story so rare. While most European populations were reshaped by waves of conquest and migration, the Lithuanians stayed same. When modern geneticists compared Lithuanian DNA to that of ancient skeletons found across Europe, they couldn't believe what they saw. Lithuanians weren't like Western Europeans, who showed heavy influence from southern farmers and later invaders. They weren't like Scandinavians, who had waves of Viking and Germanic mixing. They weren't like Slavs, who mixed more with steppe nomads and Central Asians. Instead, Lithuania stood almost alone, genetically closer to ancient hunter-gatherers and early Indo-Europeans than any other living population. If you want to see what the first Europeans looked like, look at a Lithuanian. In a world that keeps moving faster, the story of Lithuanian DNA is a quiet reminder that sometimes the most powerful thing you can do is endure. Empires collapse, languages die, beliefs change, but the blood remembers. And in that blood is a story that belongs to all of us. Because every human being carries a fragment of someone ancient, someone forgotten, someone who refused to disappear. One study found that modern Lithuanians are genetically closer to ancient Europeans who lived 4,000 years ago than almost anyone else alive today. That's like looking at the past through a mirror, not through ruins or artifacts, but through living people. Even modern geneticists describe it this way. If you want to study the DNA of the first Europeans, study the Lithuanians. Because in their blood, the Ice Age hunters, the steppe herders, and the early forest dwellers all still coexist. The people of Lithuania didn't just inherit the past, they preserved it, almost perfectly, through every empire, every invasion, every storm of history. Lithuanians carry unusually high levels of ancient hunter-gatherer ancestry, far more than Western Europeans. It's as if the waves of migration that changed the rest of Europe somehow stopped at the Baltic forests. This made Lithuania a kind of genetic time capsule, a window into what ancient Europe once looked like. And there's another twist. Deep in the genetic code of modern Lithuanians, scientists also found traces that link them to the legendary steppe nomads, the same horse-riding tribes who once thundered across the plains of Eurasia. These were the Yamnaya people, the ones who spread the Indo-European languages, weapons, and customs across half the world. They were the ancestors of warriors, herders, and conquerors, and their blood still flows through Lithuanian veins. That means the Lithuanian story isn't just northern, it's also eastern. It stretches from the icy Baltic to the endless grasslands of the steppe. For thousands of years, these genes mixed and survived, untouched by the great empires that reshaped Europe. While Rome rose and fell, while Vikings sailed west, while crusaders marched east, the Baltic lands stood apart, isolated, quiet, but enduring. Even religion couldn't erase that ancient identity. Lithuania was the last pagan nation in Europe to officially convert to Christianity, as late as the 14th century. But in many ways, that old spirit never disappeared. The songs, the rituals, and even the connection to nature that defined ancient Baltic faith still whisper in the culture today. But perhaps the most surprising discovery is genetically, modern Lithuanians are closer to Bronze Age Europeans than most modern Western Europeans are. Think about that for a moment. While France, Germany, and Britain were reshaped by centuries of migrations, the Baltic gene pool changed far less. It's as if time moved slower here, like a living echo of Europe's past still walking among us today. So the next time someone asks where Lithuanians come from, remember this. They didn't just arrive from somewhere else. They stayed. From the Ice Age to the modern age, their ancestors never left. And that's what makes Lithuania not just a country, but a living piece of ancient Europe. From the first hunter-gatherers and ancient Baltic tribes to medieval warriors and modern generations, every chapter has left its mark on the Lithuanian genetic code. If you've enjoyed this journey through the unique DNA of Lithuania, let us know in the comments. Have you ever taken a DNA test and discovered some Lithuanian roots? Or maybe you've always wondered where your family's Baltic features or traditions come from? Share your stories, we'd love to hear them. And don't forget, if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more deep dives into human origins, and hit the notification bell so you never miss an upload. Aciu ir sudae. Goodbye for now.